Hey guys, so happy Halloween to you guys, and Feliz Dia, well, I don't know if I want to say Feliz, but anyway, good on you if you're celebrating Dia de los Muertos, for those of you, or All Hallows Eve, or however you want to put it. It's that day, you know, October 31st, so I always think this is a very interesting day. It's not my kind of holiday. As you can see, I don't dress up or anything, but I can see how many people have so much fun. I just came back home from my work at the elementary school, and you know, it's always interesting to see kids and teachers dressed up. I've seen a bunch of different interesting stuff. I think there was a group of students who dressed up like cowboys and cowgirls. Don't know why is that a thing, but that was interesting to see. They had like handkerchiefs down there with the cowboy hat. One girl in opposition to that, I guess, or in contrast to that, there was a girl who had like, you know, like the typical or the stereotypical Native American clothing and was like Native American. I really got to only see one class today, and I'll get to talking more about why that was. So it wasn't a fun day for me. There was a really big bad news that the teacher I work with and we had to kind of swallow. Really bad news, but that's why we only had one class. But that one class they had pretty cool costumes. What was interesting to see was kind of like a couple of kids were dressed from like George Lucas movies. There was an Indiana Jones, there was Luke Skywalker, and then angsty Anakin Skywalker, you know, from like Star Wars Episode 2 and 3. Yeah, those movies. So I don't know why he chose to be like the character that most people do not like, but he was the teenage or the older Anakin. And there was Darth Vader too, but without the helmet. He just had the whole Darth Vader outfit. So I just joked to the kids like, hey, you guys could even like do like a George Lucas movie here. And they got really excited talking about that a bit. But that was the class that had, there was another girl who has, is usually like, she's really like, she's tall, she has red hair, but today she came to class, she was like wearing these like black pants, she had like netted stocking on her elbows, and black tank top, and she's a fourth grader, I think, by the way. She's really tall for her age, I think. It just seems to me that way. But she's normally red hair, but today her hair was like really black. I don't know if she went so far as to dye her hair. It almost looks like she dyed it, but I kind of doubt it. I wanted to ask, but I didn't get a chance to ask if it was a wig or if she actually dyed her hair for Halloween. That's pretty insane if she did. And she also had like this blood mark on the lower part of her lip. She went all out. That was interesting. I don't know what she was trying to be, but that was interesting. There was also like it's so cute just seeing these kids all dressed up. It's really cute. There was a kindergartner dressed up in a bunny costume. Oh man, I just love being in that school, just seeing all the kids dressed up. There was a kid, the fourth grader, who like was dressed up like with a suit, like a red tie, like very like, I don't know, he looked like a politician. He could have played, you know, I asked him if he was dressed up as the president. Very well could have been, but he's like, no, not the president. But just seeing that was a good day. But the bad news is that our classroom has to be moved to a room downstairs. This is horrible news. The classroom that I'm a tutor in is a science classroom, and I support a science teacher. And that, you know, and she's been a teacher in this room for years. You know, there's a lot of things that's been accrued over the years in this classroom. She has a closet, and inside that closet are things that we use for all the grades in the school, you know. There's in schools, you know, there's a teacher for the fourth grade, you know, there's a fourth grade teacher, there's a third grade teacher, but a science teacher in Brooklyn, New York, we teach all grades, really. You know, some classes are kindergartner classes, some classes are first grade classes, some, you know, I've tutored and I've met, you know, I had classrooms that were like kindergarten classes, pre-K even. First grade, third grade, fourth grade, and a fifth grade special ed class. We haven't had a second grade class. I haven't experienced it, but that's maybe because I'm only working on Mondays and Thursdays, but she works with all grades. So, you know, there's a ton of stuff in her closet. All that's got to be moved. The problem is the room we're moving to is a much horrible room. You know, it doesn't have a closet. That's a huge problem. It doesn't have a sink. That's a gigantic problem. It's a science classroom. So if you can imagine, there's tanks all over the place. We have living creatures all over the place. We have cages, two cages for guinea pigs. We have crickets. We have lizards, hermit crabs, frogs. We also just set up a tank for a trout. So we put trout eggs in there and they just hatched. So they're like tiny little trouts in the back, in the very back of the room. There's a ton of living stuff. And if we don't have a sink, we can't do that anymore. And that's a really big disappointment because it's such a fun learning experience for kids. So if we move, well, it's not if, when we, after we end up moving, we're not going to be able to do the trout experiment or things like that anymore. So that's a huge bummer. The room that we are supposed to be moving to is also super dirty. And the way that the administration has kind of set up is like, it's so unfair. It's so like, you know, it feels like shit has been just handed to this teacher that I support and work with. It's just the administration just made a decision. And the decision must have been made quite some time ago, but she learned about it yesterday. And we're the whole day, pretty much today, I was helping her, you know, pack stuff into boxes. Well, actually make boxes, pack stuff into boxes, and just kind of prepare to move, which is ridiculous. You know, this is not what a teacher should be doing, moving to a different classroom. It's like all the responsibility was put on her shoulder for some reason. And who knows who has to clean the dirty room that we're moving downstairs. The reasoning behind this, I guess, is because, the reason is simple. There's a new fifth grade class that's going to start, and that class is going to be the classroom that we're in. So the new fifth grade teacher has been just hired, and they're going to use the classroom that we are in currently, and we are supposed to move downstairs. The reason is because we're in the second floor, the first floor, actually. We're in the first floor, and all the first floor is kind of the upper classes, third grade classes, fourth grade classes, and fifth grade classes. Downstairs is the lower grade classes, like the basement floor is the second grade, first grade, and kindergartners and pre-kindergartners. So that's the reason, you know. Science class doesn't have a designated class. So that's why we're being moved downstairs to this room that no one's using. Doesn't have air conditioner, doesn't have a closet, doesn't have a sink. It also has weaker sunlight. Remember, we have living things all over the place. And that's a problem. So I don't think we're going to be able to do much experiments or investigations or scientific inquiries with living things after we move down there. So that's really disappointing. It's also frustrating that the administration just decides and puts it all on the shoulders of the teacher. The teacher had to talk with like different parent volunteers to see how this could be done, but no support from the school administrative staff whatsoever. And I guess it's just seeing this, it just makes me realize, like, man, like I can't imagine like being a teacher. I know I made a video where I talked about like, you know, how much I respect the job of the teaching profession, but it's so you know, the education field is just, you know, feels like a very, and so she's also really jaded, this teacher, so far. You know, she's worked this many amount of years. She was very passionate when she started. She was really gung-ho. In fact, she had to move into a new classroom before, and she kind of did everything on her own before. But now she's kind of, you know, she's had it. You know, enough is enough, you know. And they didn't even give her support or anything. And it turns out the custodians, you know, we set up boxes, and apparently, you know, the custodians, like, didn't know about this whole move thing. Like, there was a huge communication issue here. Anyway, that's why today was not a good day. We had one class, and it's pretty frustrating, you know. And most of the time, today was the day where I went to work and it actually felt like a dreaded job. You know, I was doing stuff that, like, I really like interacting with kids and tutoring them. I like coming up, you know, assisting with lesson plans, but today was none of that. It was like manual labor, data entry, the really just jobby stuff, you know, worky stuff. I mean, I'm happy to help out the teacher, but it's just the way the school has handled this kind of move to this basement floor that is horrible, and we don't know who's going to clean it. We don't know who's going to help you move. You have all this stuff. We don't know who's going to help you pack. It's kind of on your shoulders to do this, to move to a horrible room to prepare for this fifth grade teacher who's going to use your room that you've been using for like 10 years, you know? It's really just kind of, I don't know, this is not how it should be done. So that was kind of my day today at work, and kind of gives me a good insight of like how, at least this is one example of how the education system can be like, from the teacher's perspective. It's very insightful yet frustrating to have witnessed and experienced this.